morning at Wisconsin's Morning News. We're at 6:54, and Lori Nickel, two-time Sports Writer of the Year, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, is with us at this time on Tuesdays. We're day one, Lori, into our new format here.
It's going
great. I don't know. How do you think it's going?
I love it.
Thank you.
It's a soft launch. There are a few things that are a little bit clunky. As we mentioned, we started the show at 6 o'clock this morning instead of 5 o'clock, and there are some formatic changes that you'll be noticing. For the most part, it should sound the same, but we're still figuring some things out. So Lori comes in today, and Eric and I are kind of talking with Pancake, who produces the show in the back. We're like, what about this? Should this go here?
Oh, my gosh.
How do we look today? We look organized?
You look tan and refreshed, at least, so and happy. This is,
Thank you.
I'm glad you're here. I wanted to talk to you about an article that you had posted on JS Online recently about this young lady, a local swimmer, who's going to make a run at the Olympics, but not for the U.S. team. And there are stories like this of people who have lineage to other countries who try to find a way to make the Olympics in any way they can.
Right. Amie Barrow is 19 years old. She's from Shorewood, and she literally went from a canceled high school season there during the pandemic, just like all those kids did, and missing prime recruiting time for colleges, to winning the state championship not once but three times, three different levels. And then she's a walk-on at Brown University, and by the way, pre-med, so, smart.
Oh, so she's smart, right. Too. Go, great.
I know. It's like,
not fair.
I want her to, can you save me or run for president, one of the two, medical or whatever. But now she's such a good swimmer, and her times have caught up with her ability and her potential because she's in the water and able to do the regimen that she wants to do. She realized at Brown, where she swam very well and even qualified for the Ivy League championships, this really prestigious event, she realized she had the times to qualify for her father's native country, which is the Gambia. So she lives in Shorewood since she was 8 years old. But her mom is from Finland and her dad is from the Gambia. And her mom said, hey, you could swim in the Olympics. All you have to do is go to Japan later this month and qualify at the World Championships. Oh. So there are certain caveats. She has to do this international competition, I believe, in about a week and a half. But she just has to represent the country. And with her times that she's been posting, she'll be in.
Is this unprecedented or does this happen from time to time?
This does happen. When I went to Beijing for the Winter Games last year, I covered a woman from California who was a snowboarder for Malta. And so if you have the lineage, if you're the generation above you is from one of these countries, from another country, you can qualify. It doesn't mean that you're going to be a medal contender.
Right.
It doesn't mean that you're going to even make it past the qualifying rounds to semifinals or anything like that. But it means that you can get a ticket. And there's different ways to qualify. Different countries have different spots that are just guaranteed to them. Other countries, you have a certain number amount that they can allot to people. And so the Gambia wanted her on the team and wants this arrangement to happen.
I just saw Bonnie Blair last week, who is not only one of the great speed skaters of all time, one of the great Olympians of all time, hands down, last week. And we were talking, Lori, about just how hard it is to be among the elite on the planet in any discipline.
And that's what Amie is interested in. She's interested in another challenge. She's not going to take a year off of school. She's still going to be.
So in her free time, she's going to be in the Olympics.
She's a remarkable young woman, and she likes this challenge. It's a great opportunity to swim internationally, and the Olympic experience is so unique. Some of us have been debating whether or not the Olympics are going to stick around. There's a lot of financial implications, environmental implications. What if they're two generations from now, we don't have the Olympics anymore? So she's really taking advantage of this opportunity to see what she can do with her times, and she has a year that she can still improve. But again, she's still going to school. It's just a remarkable young woman.
The story is up at JS Online right now. Lori Nickel with us on Tuesday mornings. Great to see you, Lori. Good stuff.
Great to see you. Thank you.